who's awake when this candle's burning? Them Creole babies, thin and brown and downright lazy, and they run just like a river, a little way.
Hey guys, welcome to Southern Girl Knits, episode 42. Yay! It's so good to be back talking to you guys. my voice is a little scratchy between the debate tournaments and the weather, you know. So I'm Tish. I'm your hostess. Yeah. if you're new, welcome. Awesome. If you're one of my regulars, welcome back. And I've missed talking to you guys because I've been gone a lot and I'm going to be gone a lot. 2015's been crazy for us and the end of it's been crazy too. So I went to Louisiana for Thanksgiving to visit family and that was awesome, except for the fact that Russ didn't get to go. He got a promotion at work, and so he got stuck on call. So me and the kids went to Louisiana by ourselves, and normally that wouldn't be such a big deal, except that our anniversary falls during Thanksgiving week, and that means I spent my 16th wedding anniversary without him, but that was okay, because I love him every day, not just one day a year. So it was all right. But I did get to spend that day with some friends that I have not seen since high school. We got together and just a core group of us. You know, I went to a rather large high school, especially large considering it was back in the 90s. Gonna show my age, right? And so we got together and had dinner and we had a wonderful night. It was so good. It was so funny because I literally haven't seen these people in 22 years. And it was like we picked up right where we left off. We just had so much fun that night. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. And I enjoyed the trip. The whole trip was great. It always is. I mean, I get to spend time with my family. You know, my one niece. My nephews, my sister, my mom, my dad, and my in-laws, they're wonderful. I had just a great trip. And if you're following me on Instagram, you saw some of the pictures of that. And I'm actually going back to New Orleans this weekend for a debate tournament. So may or may not get to squeeze in some time with the family while I'm there. It would be nice, but debate tournaments are usually back to back, you know, there's not a lot of time. So I'm really actually looking forward to going to New Orleans. We'll be really close to the Garden District and Magazine Street. And I know that means absolutely nothing to you, but it means something to me. I'm really excited about it. Let's see. I never got to show you guys pictures from my birthday. That's Russ and I getting ready for my birthday. We went to Copeland's in Little Rock, which is awesome. Like, seriously. Yeah. Stuffed crab. Stuffed shrimp. Yeah, needless to say, I was quite full. This is a shrimp fettuccine with crab cakes. Yeah, I don't know. It's just, yeah, it's so good. And then this is a picture from, I know that I don't follow anybody but family on Facebook. And I'm not sure that I put this picture on Instagram, but it's titled, "This is what life with a teenager is like." This is me and Lainey. Yeah. We were taking pictures and I surprised her and she's just like, I'm 15. I'm too old to have a mom. We started putting up our Christmas tree and not a very good picture, but Christmas trees are really hard to get good pictures of. And there is just so much glare. Probably making you guys nauseous. Maybe that's a better picture. But yeah, we got our tree up and it's exciting and I love it. And my whole house is all Christmassy and it's wonderful. We have our Christmas village set up and our manger scene and rest decorated on the outside. And yeah. I bought hot cocoa last night. So we had hot cocoa last night with peppermint. Got the peppermint candy canes. And yeah, that's good. Oh, and I made stuffed bell peppers for dinner. Actually, Russ and I both did. Look how good those turned out. That's them cooking. They're still raw at that point. But oh my gosh, we tore these suckers up. They were so good. Yeah. That's good. So it's been fun times here. Like, seriously, like, we've been having some awesome fun times. And yeah, I love this time of year. Have I mentioned that before? Not sure if I've told you that or not. I love this time of year. By the way, I know I haven't worn this hat in a while, so some of you may not remember. This is the Hurricane hat. And it's done out of the Knit Picks Swish Tonal in the, it's like Thunderhawk colorway. I'm not sure what the colorway is. Thunder something. But it's the only one that looks like this. It's the gray tonal. And I'm freezing. I'm sitting in the house freezing to death. So I'm like wearing one of Russ's coats. So I know I look all bundled up, but I'm cold. And you're going to love me anyway, right? And I'm drinking my coffee because, yeah, it's one of those little coffee cozies that you could buy and make yourself at Michael's. And I guess I did this last year. And I love this thing. And it's just one of the, the reusable Starbucks cups. And it works well. And I'm drinking almond amaretto coffee that I got while I was in Louisiana. I buy coffee beans when I'm there so that when I get home, I can grind them and have good coffee. So almond amaretto. So good. And it's really early in the morning right now. Can you tell? I don't look quite awake. That's not my first cup of coffee. It's my second cup of coffee, which is why I can talk to you. But when I finish it, I'll be downright pleasant. So let's get on to some knitting because that's what we're talking about, right? Right? Okay. So you know about my Christmas sock saga, trying to get all my Christmas socks done, right? So you saw that I got mine done and Lainey's done and Reese's done. And so I was concerned because I still left two boys that I was knitting socks for and kind of made me nervous for a little while there because, you know, boy socks are a little more to knit. They're not blocked yet, but they're done. Will's socks are done, and I put in the Room to Grow. That's what I call it. I totally made this pattern up, but I call it the Room to Grow stripe. Whoop, there we go. Can you see it? Let's see if we can do better than this. I can do better than this. I can give you a better picture. There we go. See? Because he is a teenage boy, and I can put that child to bed, and he will wake up the next day and, like, be 6 inches taller. It's the craziest thing. Like, seriously, what's up with that? I guess that's what boys do, right? It's a boy thing. So I gave him room to grow in these because last year the boys grew out of their Christmas socks rather quickly, which works out well for Lainey because bless her heart, her feet don't grow. She's got little pixie feet and they never grow. So she just takes the boy socks because that child loves hand knit socks. So done. And this is knit out of the Knit Picks Felici. And I have the tag. Go me. It is in their special reserve, and it's the Baker Street. Baker Street colorway. I'm going to get that there for you in a minute. And it came out wonderfully. Love it. The only thing that I don't love is that they do this. I don't know what makes them do this. They did this with another pair that I knit. See how this one stripe looks really big as compared to the other stripes that are in it? I guess the bottom of the foot would be a better place to show that to you where the heel is done. So, see, small stripe, small stripe, small stripe, small stripe. And then this really big stripe. And it confused me until I realized that when you look at it in the right light, it is two different colors. And maybe you can see it on the computer, maybe you can't. I have to kind of look at it with outside light to tell, but it is two different colors. I just don't know why they've had to put them so close together, because it just looks like one gigantic gray stripe. It did it on the top too. See there, you can kind of see that maybe it's two different colors. So, not sure what their thinking was on that. They could have broken that up better with the other colors. I don't know. Not that big of a deal. The simple fact is, another pair of Christmas socks. Done. Which only leaves me with Russ's socks. And as you know, I showed you last time that he has one sock finished. So I've shown you that. One sock done. And I turned the heel on his second sock yesterday. Fish Lips Kiss heel, of course, that I love so much. And I'm going down the foot. And that's it. I'll be done with his. And it's December the 8th. Yes, December the 8th. Not too shabby, right? The only problem is I'm going to New Orleans with the debate team this weekend. And that is normally an 8-hour drive, but we're going to be on a school bus, and I imagine we're going to have to stop and all that kind of stuff. So we're looking at like 9 hours on a school bus. And you think, wow, that's like a lot of knitting time. And yeah, no, you can't knit on a school bus. You just can't. It's just, no. I downloaded, I got hubby to download me Orson Scott Card audiobook, Earth Unaware, and I believe it's a trilogy, but it's the prequel to Ender's Game. You might know that because they put the movie out, but I read the book because they're way better, right? Yeah. So this is like a prequel to that series, and so I'm really excited about that. So I will be listening to my book and trying to knit. We're just going to see. I'm just not foreseeing a lot of knitting time happening because we're going to be gone for 4 days. So, yeah, I might not have too much to show you guys next week. I don't know. We'll have to see. We'll just have to play it by ear, right? Okay. So, last thing I want to show you guys. You know that I'm knitting on my sweater, and it hasn't gotten a lot of love because I've been traveling so much. I went home for Thanksgiving, and then the very next weekend, which was this past weekend, we had a debate tournament. So, the sweater is just way too big and bulky to pack with me. And so it hasn't gotten any love, but that's okay because I've been loving on other things, like finishing up those socks that makes me so happy. And I've also gotten a good bit of knitting done on my zigzag scarf by, there is no name, but with such a unique name for the pattern, I'm sure you can find it on Ravelry. And I don't think it's a free pattern. I got it when I bought the yarns at the, sorry, my allergies are acting up. So sorry. when I bought the yarns, the yarn store owner gave me the pattern. So it was like a kit, I should say. So I know you've seen this before, but you haven't seen it in a while. So I want to share it with you because and I know I say that every time, and I know you guys are probably getting tired of hearing it, but this makes me so happy. Okay, so it starts down here. Ah! I have gotten a lot done on this bad boy, right? It's been the most wonderful knit project that I have done in a long time because it requires, it requires just enough thinking that it is, it keeps your attention, but you don't have to really concentrate and focus on that because it's just repeats. So it requires just enough focus to keep it interesting, but not enough focus that you can't do something else. You can't watch television or visit with whoever is with you or anything like that. It's really awesome. I found myself picking this up a lot. Like, if I'll get bored going round and round with socks, I'll pick this guy up. And, I mean, just look at this. It makes me happy. I can't wait to finish it. And it's coming along faster than I thought because I'm not a big fan of scarves at all because it's back and forth and back and forth. And that can be so tedious. But because it's the same pattern back and forth, it doesn't, there's just something about it that just makes it not feel as tedious as it would if it were something else. I don't know. It just speaks to me and it makes me happy and I very much love it. So, yay. I like it. And you're going to be seeing it a lot of it until it is done. And who knows when that'll be because it's a scarf, so it's got to be long. You might be seeing this bad boy till next winter. So, because I finished Will's socks, and I know that I only have just the foot left on Russ's socks, when I was in Louisiana, I have to go to the knit store, right? It's a given, okay? So I had to visit my knit store there. And before I left, I knew that I was going to jump on the bandwagon and knit this hat. Granted, I'm probably late to the game. Everybody else has probably already knit a million of these. I'm always late to the game, but that's okay. I don't care. I knit things that make me happy. And when I saw this popping up all over Instagram, I was like, I so want to knit that. Like, seriously, this hat is awesomeness. And I'm going to knit it. See if I can get you a good picture. Yeah. Can you see that? Can you see the cute? Let's see if I turn it the right way. Here we go. Look how cute is that? How much adorableness is this? And to make it even better, free. Totally free. So yeah. And I guess I should tell you the name of it so that you can go get it yourself because you know you want to knit this. It is the Babble Hat by Donna Smith. And like I said, when I downloaded it, it was free. I hope that it's still free. If that gets you excited and you want to knit it, I hope that it's still free. It might have been a free if you get it between now and now. Like this week it's free. I don't know. Maybe I just hit the right time and got it for free. But I'm super excited about it. So while I was there, I had to buy needles because you know that I like to knit hats, right? I can't help it. I like to knit hats, which means that I have hats on my needles in my UFOs. So what's a girl to do? Buy more needles. Totally justifiable, right? So what I did was I went and I did save myself some money because I went stash diving for the yarn for this, okay? I don't have the blue with me. The bag wasn't big enough for it. So the bottom of the hat is done in one color. And then, of course, the sheep are black and white. And then the top of the hat's done in another color. So for my bottom color, I chose this Malabrigo, which I love because I've already started knitting it up. Look how pretty that is. Let me see if I can get everything out of the way for you here. I love this. I love these colors. It reminds me, like, when I put the sheep on, I think it's going to look like they're in a green pasture. And I have a beautiful Malabrigo Rios that in... See, I don't think I have anything. Actually, no, the bag that I have it put in, it's kind of, the blue is this color. And it has a little bit of a tonal effect to it. I'll make sure to show it to you guys next time. Next time I'll probably have the hat done. So I'm really super excited. And when I was in Louisiana, of course, I got my needles, the Knit Picks Dreams. You start in a size 6 and then you move up to a 7, which those needles are with the blue yarn. Sorry about that. But I do have this to show you. So the little sheepies are going to be knit out of this. Can you see how fuzzy it is? I mean, like, how cute are those sheep going to look? They're going to actually have some fuzz to them. It's, I don't know, and it's so squishy. Like, makes me happy. So, super stoked about that. And that's kind of what I've been focusing on. I've been knitting it. I just cast this on last night. And while I was sitting at the high school waiting for Lainey to get out of debate practice, I did this much. Like, it's just knitting itself up, which when you get really excited about a fun new project, I find that they knit themselves up. It's the craziest thing. Oh, the colorway on this is Mariposa. I forgot to say that. Had it in my stash for so long. But, yeah, super excited. And because I've really been into, like, I've enjoyed the color work that I've been doing lately. I don't know. It's making me happy. So I will probably work on that after I get done with you guys because I'm still watching Bones. I think I'm getting towards the end. I've got to be getting towards the end. I know it still comes on, but I think I'm getting towards the end of what's available on Netflix, which is like 10 seasons maybe, and I think I'm on season 8. So, really excited about that. Good show. Fun times, although you really cannot eat when you watch that show because they get a little graphic with the dead bodies. Ooh, yeah. So, other than that, I am reading my book. I think I told you before, you have to excuse me while I get on my phone, because I've told you before that I set challenges for myself on Goodreads every year, and I try to kind of update, like, not update, I try to one-up myself every year. Like, last year, my goal was to read 25 books that year, and I did it. So this year, I was like, well, I'll put the challenge at 30 books, and, oh, I didn't log my last book in. I need to do that. So I am at 28 of 30 books. So I've only, and I finished a book that I haven't put in here. I had to pre-read a philosophy book for Lainey because that's my child. So I read a philosophy book that I got to put in here. But 28 out of 30. So I'm really at 29 out of 30. And I've got the Orson Scott Card book that I'm going to listen to on the trip. So it's very likely that I'll finish that. And I'm reading The Night Sister by Jennifer McMahon. Oh my gosh, so good. I love her books. She has quite a few books out, and I love her books. They are really, really good. They're a little reminiscent of the way Gillian Flynn writes, the author of Gone Girl. And, I mean, not exactly. It's not like they, but it's just similar. I don't know. They're just really good. Just in case you want to spell her name, see The Night Sister by Jennifer McMahon. And then I have another one from her, Promise Not to Tell. And has anybody read All the Light We Cannot See by Anthony Doerr? I heard good things about it, so I downloaded it. I bought it and downloaded it, and I opened it up, so it shows that I've read it, but I didn't read it. I just opened it up, and then ended up, that Night Sister book came out, and I was like, oh, I've got to read this book, because I love her book. So, I just kind of want to know, is it good? Like, is it worth, you know, my time? Because I've heard good things about it, in the sense that people enjoyed reading it, but I'm not even sure what the book's about. Isn't that terrible? So, but, you know, I'm kind of weird. I have to have books on my Kindle at all times. Like, it makes me nervous if I have any less than 10 books that I haven't read on my Kindle because, you know, I just gotta have books. It's like a crutch. I don't know. So, I think I will meet my reading goal. So, I'm trying to decide if I want to up it next year or leave it the same. I'm really not sure. So, let's see. Is that everything? I'm looking around, like, you know, looking at my things because you can't see the things. Podcaster confession. Still in my pajamas. Yeah. That's me. Still in my pajama pants. Ain't even lying. I literally, like, just got the kids off to school. So, still in pajama pants because they're warm. And I am cold all the time, and it is really cold. So, or it's cold to me. I should say that. It's cold to me. It's, yeah. So, I think that's it. I think that's all I have for you guys. I may or may not see you next week, depending on, like I said, I'm going to New Orleans, and I'll be gone for like 4 or 5 days, and it's not a knitting conducive environment. Is that right? Can you see? Trying to sound all smart. So I'm not sure I'll get any knitting done, but who knows? Who knows? And after this trip, life will very much slow down for us. Lainey, the kids have semester tests coming up. Lainey got exempt from them because she's on the Freshman Academy has a policy that if you have all A's and B's, you can be exempt from the semester test. So she gets to stay home an extra week. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'll have a partner in crime for a whole extra week. Shopping buddy. So, yeah, that's it. I will see you guys hopefully in 2 weeks, and I hope that everything's awesome. Don't stress yourself out with Christmas knitting. Just, it's all good. Knitting's supposed to be fun and relaxing, not stressful. So don't stress yourself out. Just be okay if you don't finish your Christmas knitting. It's okay. I release you from that. But other than that, that's all I got for you guys. I hope you guys are having an awesome week. I hope you have an awesome month. I hope that your Christmas decorations and or Hanukkah or whatever you celebrate, I hope that you're having an awesome, awesome, awesome December and fun times. And don't forget to always be awesome. Bye, guys.